Hello. Today is Tuesday, July 6th, I believe. Matt Wright here.
Jeremy Elliott.
Well, this is the first video of Tuesday, so I think we're gonna do it as we usually do it. Just sometimes it takes us a second to warm up, and we do it by talking and passing vibes and energy back and forth and building on it. And this is how we do it. We've already been talking some, sharing ideas, but we were thinking about we got a couple people wrote us yesterday and helped a couple people yesterday in regards to people that they knew that have died. And we got someone else last night that called in or wrote in, asking about her granddad. Dominique, but you know who you are, but
yeah.
We're going to get with you. I'll look for a message from us because he's coming right through. We were chatting with him this morning.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he wants to chat. He'll talk with you.
Definitely.
And probably got a couple other people want to come through. That's my impression. It's not just him. So, that goes to Dominique. I just want to say that.
Yeah.
But we got the message.
Yeah, we got the message. There's some other people that we want to get back to and get done.
A lot of them are just spirits.
Yeah,
all of them are spirits.
Yeah,
I know.
But,
I thought. Okay.
Yeah, I'm saying we got to
get back to them, too.
Yeah.
We got a long list. We're trying to get caught up. We've been running a little behind on some of this stuff. But, let me see what else I could throw out. To the dude Justin from last night. And we can say now, your dad's on the other side. Like, he was in this little, found him in what we call a self-imposed exile dimension.
Right.
He must have turned back and it was scared to go through the portal to the other side. It looked like that. But he went through last night, so he's all right now. And then your uncle already on the other side.
Yeah, he was already over.
Straight.
Over.
And
we took your
dad,
so
biological dad.
And his father through the portal, we helped move him along. So hopefully
Lord Buddha took him too.
Yeah.
He was there with a group of his monks and us.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's a whole lot of us. He's got some good help on the other side.
Absolutely.
And then your uncle if he wants it. Just so you know that, or anyone, for that matter, or you, goes for anybody watching this, if you really want the help, you can get it.
That's right.
If you accept it, so, I guess we can comment on this, too. We were watching the news last night and this morning, saw the shit that had happened down in Hopewell with that dude accidentally shooting himself in the head of a young boy, and then he ended up dying a couple of hours later at the hospital. But that's a tough situation. Yeah, I can imagine, I can feel it.
Yeah, it's probably a very sad situation for the family too,
it's a
messy situation, we try to say, remember that nobody ever really dies, I want to say that, that people are there, they cross over and just trying to get back to us too, so just keep your eyes out for those little signs, those little smells, that song, that idea that makes you think of your son or your brother, or your friend, family member here, and know that they're trying to come through, just keep a positive outlook, do the best you can. I'm sorry to hear about your death and the family.
But, he's got some adjusting to do, but, he's just shaky as hell now,
Just
shaky, he doesn't know what to do next yet. He's trying to figure out what to do.
Yeah, I'm feeling him. He's not really,
he's all right.
He's not really, adjusted 100% necessarily right
now.
Yeah, because he just took a, he just went from one body to another, so he just kind of shook up a little bit,
Unexpectedly, kind of popped through, he didn't expect his day to go like that.
Right.
You know, I didn't expect to end up in the spirit world.
No, I didn't expect to end up
on Sunday night, you know, on Monday. So,
exactly.
But yeah, he's all right. You know, like, he knows how to reach us. And now, you know, he knows what we do. We made that, took care of that.
Yeah.
Just like we do this for a lot of people all the time. Mm-hmm. So it's no big deal at all. Just what we do. So get in touch with us if you want to talk to us about it. You've got the Facebook address and phone number on here. So, you know, we're happy to help, you know. But just want to throw that out too, something that I thought needed to be said. And
one thing I had a question about, this is kind of off the subject kind of question, but Matt and I recently and in the past have discussed making children book ideas, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, we've had some children book ideas, and I was just curious as what the audience would think about that, you know, that we could write some books maybe to help some children's books maybe to help, you know, children understand and cope with death and dying differently, you know. So we have a generation of children maybe, you know, or some children in the next generation come up with a different outlook on death and dying and what happens to a person when they pass away.
Yeah, that's I've tried. I actually sat down and wrote out like a rough draft of a children's book, you know, discussing death and stuff. And
it was cool.
I didn't think it was.
Yeah,
he did.
Yeah.
You know?
That's always like hard on himself, you know. Well, both of us are, but yeah, I thought the idea was great. You know, I thought it was a good book, you know.
Well, yeah, it was the thing with animals that could talk.
Yeah, cats.
Talking with the kid, a cat, talking cats, discussing death with children in the neighborhood.
To me, was a great example of a kid's book, you know, deal with death and dying and stuff. You know, I had an idea maybe doing a book with maybe a water painting book with the monks. And
that's a good idea.
You know, it would be like real Zen or something, you know, something like that.
I'm writing it down right now, yeah. Like real Zen. Children's book.
Yeah, you know, something, you know, just maybe the kid asking, you know, what is this life about? You know, what happened when you die? Ask a lot of questions, and maybe the monk putting it to them in a way, you know, that the children can understand.
Yeah, that's a good idea. That's real good. You know, the monks could be in there talking to the child. Lord Buddha could be in there talking to, you know.
Exactly.
We do it all. Put them all in.
Yeah, I didn't draw like the light and the portal and stuff in there. You know, I don't know, man. Maybe it's an idea.
Maybe a book that explains things children might see spirits better, like portals and going out of body it when they're sleeping, like a way to for parents, like a parent got.
Yeah.
So you all children and spiritual abilities.
Yeah, to help parents know how to cope with it. Help children, you know, learn how to cope with it. Give parents an idea of what to say sometimes when the question comes up, you know. And,
oh, yeah.
You know.
That's a good idea, too. All of it. All of it is.
Both of the ideas in the book sound good to me, man. I mean, we'll see what happens, you know. But give us an answer, you know, if you do see this, and give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down what you think we should do on the kid's book or if it's a good idea or not, you know. I'm just curious.
Because they have all these other religious kids' books out there trying to teach children about their belief systems. So I think it might be about time that kids need to learn different belief systems.
Yeah.
That's the idea.
Grow up with a new thing, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Like, house and house, get high on a new thing, you know?
Yep. It's like the song, dude.
That's right.
That's a song, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't say that. That's not get high on a new thing. That's not what the title is, but that's what the lyrics say.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know, it's like new thing is what it's called. Is it? Yeah, new thing. Anyway, I'm tired today. You know, I've slept very poorly the past five, six days, averaging just a couple hours sleep on average at night. Last night I got an hour and a half of sleep. Just couldn't sleep.
Yeah.
Worth it damn. Okay. But I'm keeping on going. So forgive me if I'm a little bit slower than usual today, you know, to our audience. But anyway.